XTools Pro is one of the most popular extensions for ArcGIS desktop end users. In this video, we will demonstrate a practical example of using the XTools Pro Scale Manager tool. Setting visibility scale ranges for map layers is an essential part of the map design. At that, for the huge maps with lots of layers, group layers, and labels, this can be a real challenge in ArcMap with its dockable layer properties dialog. The task can be facilitated partly with the XTools Pro Layer Properties dockable window. Not a huge help anyways if you work with such map as the USA street map, and it does not show the whole picture of all scale ranges in the map. In order to address this, there is a Scale Manager tool provided with XTools Pro. Let's see how it can help. With Scale Manager, you can see all the map layers and their scale ranges in one window, so you have the whole picture of all scales used in the map. At that, there are many features and options provided for more effective work with map scale ranges. All scale ranges may be fitted into the visible area of the tool dialog window. For more representative view, you can change the scale type, selecting between linear and logarithmic scales. Same way in the tool settings, you can change the direction from maximum to minimum and vice versa. If there are any group layers or layers with label classes, then their influence area is highlighted when you hover the mouse cursor over such layers. Besides, each group is marked with lines on the left and right. Scale ranges can be moved as whole. For this, you can drag and drop the range line. At that, range values are shown for your convenience. When you move ranges, they are snapped to the already existing bounds and to the other ranges. Bound scale values can be entered manually. For that, double-click on the required bound. Snapping properties can be specified in the settings. Scale range bounds can be snapped to the other bounds, to the grid lines, and to the scale indicator. Scale indicator shown with a vertical green line can be used to visualize layers' visibility on the map. There are two ways available to remove scale ranges. First, enter zero or no value for the range bounds. Second, drag and drop the range bound beyond the working area. In order to create a new scale range, you can either move one of its bounds or define its value. There are three states supported for bounds: open, closed, and nominal. Bound type can be specified in the bound context menu. Open bounds are used to exclude scale value from the visible range. Open bound values are corrected when saved. One is added for maximum range bounds and subtracted for minimum range bounds. Closed bound is the default type. Its value is never corrected automatically. It is recommended to use closed bounds if you wish to control scale ranges by yourself without automatic corrections. Nominal bounds are bounds inherited by the nested element from the group root element. These can be bounds taken from the group layer or from the feature layer for nested label classes. Undefined bounds are shown with light color. All undefined bounds are nominal. There are three types of bounds that can be applied to scale ranges. First, both bounds closed. Second, maximum bound closed or minimum bound open. Third, maximum bound open or minimum bound closed. Default type can be specified in the settings. Open bounds are corrected, +1 or -1, when saved, and only for the particular modified bounds. Bound values entered manually, that is, explicitly specified, are not corrected. Groups are not only group layers, but also layers with label classes. Groups are moved same way as ranges. However, if the option Move Groups as a Whole is enabled in the settings, all elements nested in this group will be moved. If a nested element is beyond its group bounds, then it's marked with special bright color. This means this element won't be visible at the marked scales. There are several ancillary service elements available in Scale Manager. First, the Map Scale Grid. This grid corresponds to the scales of the current ArcMap document. Standard ArcMap means can be used to modify these scales. Another service element in the workspace is the scale indicator. When you move scale indicator, the range's view changes accordingly. Those ranges that will be visible on the map at the scale indicator value are highlighted with brighter color. Invisible ranges are lightened. That is, moving the scale indicator, you can see what layers and labels will be visible on the map at different scales. Scale indicator value can be specified manually. Other useful settings include show or hide map scale grid and its labels. Show or hide scale indicator. Show or hide group borders. Highlight groups on hover. Press the Save button in the lower left corner to save specified scale ranges or agree to save results when closing the tool dialog window. We won't save changes for the demonstrated map. Now let's see how we can specify scale ranges for the new map and what we can get as a result. We use the scale indicator for snapping. Scale ranges can be specified in either of supported ways. When the required scale ranges are added, we can see the result. We close Scale Manager pressing the OK button. This will automatically save new scale ranges. As we can see, all new ranges are applied to the map layers and labeled, so the map is displayed accordingly. Therefore, the Scale Manager tool in XTools Pro provides following advantages for work with scale ranges in ArcMap. Handy management of all map scale ranges in one window. You can see the whole picture of all scales used in the map and control visibility of all map layers and labels at all map scales. Range bound values are automatically corrected. XTools Pro is the number one productivity suite for ArcGIS community. Visit our website to learn more and try XTools Pro free for 14 days.